Forestry and Natural Resources at Cal Poly. Take a look at our programs, a program fully accredited by the Society of American Foresters. Cal Poly's School Forest, Swanton Pacific, is located in Santa Cruz County, where students study during weekend field trips, through special classes and internships, and assist with faculty research projects. Cal Poly and its forestry program are known for their hands-on or learn-by-doing approach to instruction. The Natural Resources Management Department works closely with professionals, agency, and industry members. However, it's always our students that count the most.
Hi, my name is Jesse. I came to Cal Poly because of the good reputation that I've heard from many different people. What I enjoy most about the forestry department is the teachers that are really hands-on, and most of the teachers have a lot of experience.
The first class that I had that actually took me on a field trip up here was just really hooked me into forestry. And I've been running around up here all weekend on a class field trip, and all I've been thinking the whole time is like, how cool is my major? Like, how many other majors get to come up here and spend a weekend in the woods tromping around?
The forestry major here at Poly is, you know, it's great. Well, you learn a lot, and it's learned by doing. So you're not always in a classroom. You're out in the, you know, you're out in the field. You're out getting your, you know, getting your hands dirty.
Probably the best thing about the school forest here is at Swanton Pacific Ranch is you can come out and get hands-on experience. We call it a playground. Teachers call it a classroom, whatever you want to call it.
I'm just totally stoked to be up in this environment. You know, you can't hear a car from millions of miles away, and it's just so beautiful and so peaceful.
The forest is actively managed, so there's logging operations, and classes will come in and do stream surveys, wildlife surveys.
One of our many study disciplines is watershed management and hydrology. This is an exciting field of study that includes topics like soil protection, erosion, sedimentation, channel stability, landslides, and stream restoration. GIS modeling techniques are used to prescribe suitable practices for land managers.
The tub has 24 bottles hosed right over the next bottle. Here, it'll allow it to ride up into the column of water.
0.5. Depth is 1.1.
As a forestry student, you'll learn to use the latest measurement technology. This includes stream flow measuring devices, tipping bucket rain gauge, laser leveling, and precision surveying instruments. Streams in our school forest are home to indigenous coho salmon and steelhead trout. Here, a harmless fish trap is being shown to our students.
So she is a hatchery female.
I really like how well educated our faculty and staff, they really know what they're talking about.
In general, the class size for most of the laboratory classes in forestry is small enough to really have a lot of interaction with each professor.
You can talk to them anytime. If you have questions, just go ahead and ask them.
Another awesome thing about this forest is that they have a computer lab with up-to-date computers and up-to-date technology where you could compute all the information you get from out here in this forest and put it all into the computer, and it will actually give you information that you're trying to find.
We've learned about surveying up to this point kind of culminates at the school forest. We're allowed to go out on our own and shoot a bearing and find the distance from point to point.
We're measuring trees, like diameters, heights, everything.
A lot of these points are up in the trees. As you can see, it's pretty thick and steep terrain. And the relief when you finally found it, knowing that the tools you've been taught and the tools you're using actually work.
Speaking of work, over 90% of our forestry graduates find immediate employment related to their field. For example, students interested in fire and fuels management have been employed by Cal Fire, U.S. Forest Service, and city and county fire departments, among others. They fight wildland fires and conduct prescribed burns and fire risk assessments, study fire ecology, and prepare for managing disasters.
You have like a wide range of things. You have like harvesting, you have watershed, you have health, you also have like biology kind of focus classes.
One of the big reasons Cal Poly that stuck out to me is just the environment. The climate is really awesome. About my second year in Cal Poly, I decided to join up on the Cal Poly logging team. which is just a whole bunch of really cool kids doing the traditional lumberjack sports that you see generally on like ESPN outdoor games, stuff like that, you know, running on logs in the water and, you know, crosscut saws and playing with chainsaws, throwing axes. I mean, it was just a cool group of kids that just loved forestry and loved hanging out and having fun and, you know, working hard. And, it, you know, joining the clubs really helped out a lot with my academic curriculum too, because they'd be able to give me like insight, or I had a lot of upper level classmen that I could talk to and ask questions about, you know, hey, like, I'm having trouble with this assignment, you know, how do I do this?
Cal Poly forestry graduates are career ready when they leave the university. They fill a much needed role in society as they protect, manage, and sustain our forest and natural resources. We invite you to join our team.
So it ended up being a place that I really did want to spend 4 or 5 years of my life, and I was really happy that I chose to go to Cal Poly.